Well, it just makes, gives me goosebumps.
That's usually my spot.
Oh, that's, oh, this is.
It'll keep it warm.
I slept today, I said it was.
A little while.
All right, sir.
I think everybody sat at the table. They're all fighting in the back room.
I think we've got probably as close as we're going to get today. Oh!
Where they were at was the city. Coming in.
Hey, how are you? Get up there.
That's Donna Sheep.
A real member.
Yeah, I'm just, I'm at. I think a lot of.
One church is a lot. Well, I'm glad it wasn't. I'm just having a virtual still, but yeah. No one ever does that. Unless something came in. We haven't gotten any.
I'm gonna swap sides so I can see everybody on this side.
I know, that's the problem. We're sitting over here, you can't see them.
No, I can't even see that by you. Good morning, Donna.
Good morning, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, thank you.
Okay, so I get started.
It's a little weird.
Our chairman is not here today. He's going to be at another event that's occurring right now. So I think for today's meeting, I'll probably go ahead and drive this agenda and we can take it through and then we can brief everybody where we're at from there. So going on the last meeting, we had, I think some of the biggest talking points that we had were some of the community of interest groups that needed to be established, and we really needed to put names to those groups. So I want that to be a big focus for today so we can get some of these projects and such that are being proposed on the table and discussed and make sure they fit. Real quick, I want to jump down to the last bullet for the budget. We're waiting on the capital requests to come so we can bring those to the budget subcommittee. Do we know if those have all been collected? Are we ready to bring those to the budget subcommittee?
I know they're being worked on and gathered together. Basically, initial judgment call of what is capital, what's not capital, what's new items and what's same service budget. So the right line is being worked on. So I think they're about ready. At least I think we can start the flow of them for all those that are ready to go. So
okay,
we can walk them from one office to another.
There's I know for a fact there's quite a few in there. One of them being for the sheriff's office with the need to replace their RMS. So that's going to be a big one that needs to be on the table. And with that, let's jump up to bullet point one with the COI for that group for public safety that needs to be driving that one. We need to adopt members for that COI. So with Beverly taking minutes from the IT side of the house. Probably going to put Bob in the mix. You're going to regret coming today because I won't be looking at you. You're probably going to turn in everything to Bob. I think.
Sit over here.
Yeah. Exactly. Bob Langley, Van Mandakunas, of course yourself, and me. John, who do you want from the GIS side on that group?
It would probably be Mike.
Mike Hoff.
Okay.
Danny from the fireside.
Chief Wallace.
Chief Wallace. Kevin Wallace. Just Kevin.
Yes.
Okay. From the E911 side, I'm definitely going to say Pat Giordano. She's going to want to be engaged in that. And you might want to go ahead and put down Michelle Bridges. And then from the SO side.
Probably me. I'd say Leon for sure.
Leon DuPont.
James Cutcliffe. Probably Cindy Thacker as well.
And yourself?
Yeah. Just more. Sit back on. What about EMS? Do you think they would have a problem?
You know what? I'll let Kevin Wallace probably decide that one as we get engaged in. If we need to bring them halfway in, then we can. I mean, they don't really utilize any of the systems. They don't use any mobile CAD or anything like that.
Dispatching part.
Well, that's dang
the whole.
Right. So I think when we, if we cross that bridge and we need them engaged,
she has the authority to speak on my behalf.
Now this is for public safety, right?
Public yeah, it'd be for the COI. Public safety COI.
Any other department?
I don't think so.
You know what? I would request that Larry Holzcall be put in there just so that he's involved in the beginning.
That's a good idea. Yeah.
And so then he doesn't have to catch up when we get to that point.
More meetings for
him. He's not here.
He's not here. He's
been. One of the things is making sure that there is a
compatibility
between them.
When you say the RMS, is that mean
the jail RMS
dispatch?
The Interact system.
Interact.
Using transport and supernets.
911.
Which means that obviously jail is maybe back on the table.
Yeah.
So
yes,
I would think.
Someone from
DA's office, solicitor's office, and the coroner's maybe the department. I do want to do that.
I would like Randy to do it from my office and directly.
We just need to make sure there's continuity from say between what we have and or what we are proposing. It could be that we come out and say that what we have might be able to be worked into it, or that this group is the best fit, and they already have a module that's built, so all we have to do is plug and play. And if not, then the option, keeping that option of pulling the jail RMS through Odyssey into it and let us use both sides of it.
James, do you want to be on there, or
sure.
Lizzie? Sure.
Maybe if it may, I might see.
That's probably a good starting point with them. I mean, we can grow it as we need to. It's a very ad hoc group. So as we need to pull others in, or even a whole other COI that may have something to do with it, I mean, that can be done. So let's start with that. And let's assign a lead to that COI. Well, being the RMS request, you want to be the lead on that COI. So the next topic here was if we need to establish a communication COI, there's been some talk of wanting to get a phone messaging system, specifically Vocantis or one similar to it.
You want to talk about that a little bit, because you dwelled into the Volcano stuff a long time ago with the water utility billing.
And I know that we need to have Tim Perkins and Mr. Merritt discussed it at the last meeting that we had. So, there are many people from the water side that would need to be involved. So, I guess we would need to discuss that with Tim Perkins.
The mesh of that phone messaging system, just everybody here understands, was it having multiple uses of being able to utilize on the 911 side if there was a mass casualty incident or something that required notifications to be calling to the residents. Even though we have a system, could we get one-size-fit-all type solution? So that's where the discussion came to the table. So. I would think we would probably, we could establish that if it's a proposed request. I mean, did it come in on as a capital request by anybody for 2013 budget?
I've not worked on the budget at all.
I'm almost thinking that even though it sounds like a good direction to go in order to get what we need to do, that requests are actually coming in, formal requests, that maybe we hold off on that one just a little bit and focus on some of the higher priority ones. Not that that's not high priority. And then come back and touch it, maybe at least after we're done with budget submittals.
Well, no, I would be willing to discuss it with them. I mean, we've had conversations over the last couple of years since we've worked on implementing the new software and how that ties into it with the water customers and their location and having that address information. So I'd be willing to talk to them about that, about bringing back names and their desire for importance for them for representation to ITGC.
Okay. Let's just hold off on that one for the next meeting. Let's postpone that topic to the next meeting. That'll give you a chance to talk with them. Then we can get everybody here. Again, I think we got a small crowd and most of them aren't here, so we can't and against their thoughts in the end. So.
And that one's not competing funding tax priority items. That's a separate revenue source.
Right. It's sort of a future one,
it's
or
not as time critical as the other departments are right now.
Exactly. The RMS, there is a formal request in there. So did we wait off on that?
You put in a formal request. Yeah. You filled out.
So, but that's a failing system. That's why I want that one really looked at. I mean, I say failing. Let me reword that. What used to be a fit is no longer possibly a fit, and it's time to move.
Especially with the new jail, courthouse, and all the things that come with it that we wanted to put into it. We don't know if the current system is going to be able to function like we need.
So the next bullet point.
Can we go back to the COI for public safety? I don't think we mentioned the DA's office. So I don't know if you want Leslie to talk to Penny or somebody else.
Yeah, we can come back and add them on if you want to talk to Penny. We can.
John.
Normally, John Bennett is our contact, but I would not speak for Ms. Penn in regard to who she would delegate. So,
you want us to reach out to her and ask her?
I think that would be best, okay. Just to make sure.
Let's send her email this afternoon and mm-hmm. reach out and see if she herself or.
We probably need a job.
But again, I would never speak for her.
So the next topic was a conversation we had with the courts on discussions on the possibilities of having some of their own IT-related systems. It's a big topic. There's a lot involved there. So I think what we needed to do was to get together an IT standards subcommittee to kind of look at everything that we do collectively, and then if we were to branch out certain systems, what would the root cause or a break be? We need to identify those, and at the same time, would that be detrimental to your process? And likewise, the county side.
So I think it's probably best we put together that IT standards subcommittee just to get it all on the table. You know, we have a few of us in meeting, and, you know, me in the last meeting, I may not have thought of everything, and I probably did. You know, you've got so many things going through your head. So I said we put together the standards subcommittee, and we start to look at the feasibility of doing some or whatever, whatever can be done, and with that, the cost of doing that. So, and definitely bring Larry Holzclaw in on that mix. And I think from the last meeting, we already had some designees to that standard subcommittee. We had Leon DuPont. You still okay with that? We had Lacey Blackwell from the clerk courts. We had Rick Young, Mary Jo Black from GIS, Simon Wilkes from engineering. We had Amina Cephas from finance. Is that still okay? Dennis Barron from tax commissioner, Carolyn DeKalb. Okay. And of course, put myself on there. And I would also ask that we add Dave Wendover and Jimmy Payne to that. And of course,
and me.
And you, absolutely. And as far as a chair to that COI, I'll be the chair for that. Make sure we drive that one as far as we need to. And I'll try to get that standard subcommittee meeting set up fairly quickly.
Like a part of that should be, if we're not on the committee, we at least need to tell you exactly what our wishes are.
Right, right. No, you're right. Absolutely.
And I think, it's my understanding from Judge Bagley, that part of the discussion was that Wally or some other consultant would be utilized to help us with the technical stuff.
On the issue of any of the COIs, I think the first thing we always had the COI do was to, as a group, sit down and write up a kind of a statement of work, so to speak. What's our goals? What's our objectives? In addition, of course, the chairing, but and then start putting together a presentation to this group. Very brief presentation. Here's what we're about, and get approval of that, and then get your marching orders from this group. So it would be the obvious thing, I think, for the standards committee to say, what are our priorities in terms of what we're going to address, and how we plan it.
Was this an ad hoc kind of thing, or does this come under something that they would prioritize?
No, I think it could be ad hoc.
Absolutely.
And so I would definitely, and chime in on what you said, Dawn Childress needs to be on there.
You got
Would you put yourself on
there.
That IT standards subcommittee? Because that's a topic for this subcommittee. I mean, that subcommittee can also be used in other, it will probably roll right into the RMSFBR, jail management
committee
as well at some point when we start looking at
it. It's a regular permanent subcommittee.
Make sure that everything not only met our need, but also meet what the systems and what everything's capable of.
I mean, I guess Dawn could be the representative, but it might be more of us that would come in at different times. To
right.
We could put you on there, and if you can come.
That's fine.
Yeah.
So.
Both of us are kind of representatives of the court system.
Leslie, would you like to be part of that as well?
I'll be glad to.
Did you want to consider, you're talking about IT standards committee members, maybe because of her technical background ability, Lacey?
Yeah, I think
she's
already
on there.
Yeah. She's already on.
Mm-hmm.
So the next one, and this is driven from an actual request this year, for a document management / document retention COI. So we're specifically referring to a scanning solution for the county. Obviously that can be leveraged into document management retention systems as well. Voter is driving that one for their needs. But obviously there's a bigger picture to that, especially as the IT department drives into more of a SharePoint realm with being able to store documents and things of that nature archive. So I think that that's probably a lot bigger picture than just a scanning solution for voter. I think it fits everybody. Anybody that handles a piece of paper on a daily basis or inputs data. So that being said, I would almost think that we could easily take a representative from every department, but I think that would be an extremely big COI. So I think we need to start with a core COI for that one and then be able, since it's ad hoc, be able to grow it and call in those as we need them from departments. As we start looking at where it fits. So with that being the case, let's establish a document management / retention COI and put myself, Rick Young, Bob Langley, because you're the database guru, sorry. That's exactly right. I think definitely somebody from administration, you think Sonia Bush.
Patricia Ponder. She's been on all the previous committees for document management.
Right.
She's got three days pretty low.
Kelly DeKalb?
Yes.
Kelly DeKalb.
Larry?
Both of you? Both of you? Okay.
I can learn and break.
Leslie. Leslie and Judge McConnell. Sergeant Whitlock.
He's the records.
All right, so
he's up to date on all.
Jimmy Whitlock from the sheriff's office. And how about Leon DuPont as well? Leon DuPont on there.
Well, those can finance. You know, we scan.
You want yourself?
And then we also be represented from water. And I know Jill's been on
the Jill Pilcher.
Should be the documents.
So
I'm trying to think who was on it before. Mm-hmm. Yeah. We kind of had a committee a few years ago.
Yeah. Who else was on there? I think it's been
some of the years. I don't know. Work with them.
About someone from Planning, John mentioned.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I mean, they're not represented here today, so we can reach out to them. Larry?
No, I can't remember.
Okay.
Don't want any digging.
Yourself?
Well, I'm just thinking of the documents.
Or do you want us to be able to just call you
John
an ad hoc for me, Jim?
Mary Jo.
Who?
Mary Jo.
You were on it before.
Yeah. yeah, Mary Jo.
Let's start there. And obviously, we will call in other departments as we hit the topics. I mean, it's very broad. It's. I would say, depending on how far you drive this, equal size to a finance package solution when you're talking about document retention, scanning, archiving. It's big.
Well, that brings up a question. I mean, is IT going to work on a strategic plan where they want to be in 5 years?
Absolutely. There is already a strategic summary plan. The detailed plan will actually come out of governance. Being that governance has put into play for the county departments to drive where IT goes, that's going to fill in the blanks for us.
And also each COI, the goal of the COI is to actually put together, as we said, a strategy. That strategy, from an IT perspective, becomes a part of that overall strategic plan. So you have a global enterprise view. You'll have a view from the IT department, and then you have a view from each of the COIs, which really covers, it does a good job of covering the strategy from an IT perspective when you do it. And it gets the right people involved and engaged. While I'm talking, I'd also add that when you have these groups, initial groups put together, send out an email to the department head saying we have these initial group, and if they have anybody else that they feel like on document management that they want to add, then they'd have the opportunity to put somebody else in or switch somebody in. So as desired, so give them that chance so that everybody's had a chance to be included.
I answer your question, Chuck?
Yeah.
But you didn't.
Well, I'm just saying.
I don't want these COIs to be too big.
Yeah, I don't. Yeah, exactly. I don't want them.
Yeah, that's going to be too large.
Out of control. We need to be able to pull in those as we need them. So, we will keep going with those. You know, again, jumping back down to the last bullet point, the 2013 budget. He stepped out. I guess they're leaving.
I've not seen anything.
Yeah,
really.
The cap.
We
if you can.
We haven't gotten anything as a committee
okay,
yet.
Okay. All right.
I think we've been waiting on seeing these documents.
Obviously, as soon as we get those, we'll have to convene the budget subcommittee and get them engaged on looking at them, tearing them down so we can bring them back to the large committee for what our thoughts and opinions are.
Hopefully, prioritization. Yes.
Absolutely. So that being the case, it was a short meeting today because we have a lot of people out at a different event. So unless anybody's got anything they want to add, comments, anything? My ears are open.
Thank you.
Outside of Bob Langley.
We need to get in a month or so, or what do we want to do?
Absolutely. Yeah. We will meet again in approximately 4 weeks. I'll set the date. It's real hard to set dates right now, especially coming into the summer months. Everybody's on vacations and that and the other, but I'm going to do my best to work with everybody's time. So.
Okay.
That's it. All right.
Thank you.
Short and sweet to the point.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. Thank you, everyone.
Monday.
Yes, I'll be a GM.